partner on bottom is going to get an underhook, and you're going to stop. Okay? So I get my hand down on the floor below his butt. My ear is on his shoulder. Okay? Like I said, last week we were working on passing with getting under the arm and under the neck. Now we're going to do the opposite. We're going to go over the arm and over the neck. Right? So once I stop his underhook, a lot of times the person's trying to get their head in, right, which makes this really easy. I'm just going to take my right arm and flip it over his neck. I'm not trying to grab anything. I just want to get my thumb like right in between my pecs like this. So I throw my arm over his neck and I put my thumb like right in the center of my chest. Once I have that, I don't want to see you guys like trying to crank the person's head off. I just want you to get control of the head with this. Right now I'm going to throw my head and my shoulder down on the mat over here. So I'm going to use this to put him on his back. So I use this as like I'm making like a tripod here. So my head and hand are on the mat. My shoulder and elbow are on the mat on my right hand. I could potentially finish the person if I sink my weight into him here, but we're gonna use this to pass the guard. So I'm just gonna use this to pin him. I'm gonna walk my feet out to the left, take my hand, push the knee down, and just take them out. We're gonna let go of the neck for now, and then we'll work on how to finish from there later. All right, so your partner steps up, you stop their underhook, you take your free arm, the one that's not fighting the underhook, and you come over the neck. And again, don't try to chin strap, don't do anything. Just put your thumb right in the center of your chest. Right. I'm just creating a seal around his neck, and then I'm gonna throw him to the mat. So I bring my head and shoulder, my head comes out, and my shoulder goes to the mat. You'll see, it almost feels like you're somewhat unstable here, but when you get here, I want the person on my move around a little bit on you. There's not really much you can do. You're very stable. I have such a wide base. Both legs on the floor, and my hand out wide. I'm just gonna walk to the side, use my hand on the knee, slide my knee out. If you were to try to hang onto my foot, I would just tripod up. And then we'll let go of the neck once you get to the mount. Stop the underhook, wrap the neck again. I don't want to see you guys cranking on the person's neck. Just seal around the neck.
And then make yourself a really wide base. Wide with your feet, head and hand on the mat. Have the person on bottom move a little bit. And you'll see really how easy it is to control them from this position. Okay? And then you walk your feet in, hand on the floor. If they grab your foot, again, keep that shoulder on the mat. You see how my head and shoulder never leave the mat? I just tripod up, take my free leg.
More. It's underhook. So now we'll work on how to finish with this. Okay. So this gives you, this is good, especially no-gi, is to like mix up like the threat of submitting the guy with passing his guard. Okay, so there's a lot less things to hang on to in no-gi, so one of the best things you can do is to catch his neck. So he sits up, I stop it, I wrap over. Everything is gonna be the same, like my head and shoulder on the mat. So now what I wanna do is, you notice how I kind of lift up on my toes? I kind of walk my hand up my chest. You can't see what I'm doing, I'll show you in a second. I'm cinching everything up tight. The higher my hand goes, the tighter the lock around his neck goes. Now to finish, what I'm going to do is I'm going to sink my lat. My right lat is going to sink into his neck. Right? It's not a crank on his neck. I'm just slowly sinking my weight into his artery. Right? So my right wrist is flexing up my body. My right lat is sinking into his neck. It's a very like sort of slow, tight blood choke when you do this. Stop it. Wrap over again, get your thumb in the center of your chest, put him on the mat, we'll walk out, pin my knee down, and now I'm just slowly sinking my lat into his neck.
Right? The other thing that's gonna make this tighter is moving your head in an arc around his head. So as long as my head's over here, my weight's over here. The more I bring my weight on my head this way, the more pressure goes into his neck. So when you're doing this, I'm sinking my weight into him, and my head's going towards his head.
And if you watch, my shoulder and elbow shouldn't come off the mat when I do this. my wrap.
I don't want to see you guys doing this. The tendency when you do this is to go here and try to yank the person's neck off. All right, but watch. My shoulder will never leave the mat. Right.
So when I'm doing this, you see his head's in this little hole right here? The higher my hand goes, the smaller the hole gets. That's the way you do this, okay? So continue to like walk your hand up your chest. Bring your elbow towards your hip. And think about like you're squeezing a balloon under your arm. Okay? If everybody, you feel like your lat muscle here, try to flex it a little bit. That's what you want to sink into the side of the neck. Right? And again, your head's gonna go from here to line up with his head. So I wrap, catch my chest, come down on the mat, slide my knee out. Now from here, I bring my head up. All right, love you, great.